Aries Rising, welcome to your Clairvoyant Tarot reading for May 2023. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Shannan Sinclair. I'm an author, a transformation mentor, and an intuitive consultant. It is my soul's code to support you into stepping into the power and passion and purpose of your unique soul's code. And I share potent consciousness techniques that will help you harness your natural soul skills of intuition, manifestation, and reality creation. You have a whole soul system at your command, and I provide you with an operating manual. Let's get to your reading. So welcome, Aries Rising. May is on the horizon, and what is in store for you clairvoyantly, energetically, and what do the cards say? So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sit back. I'm going to get grounded. I'm going to get centered in the center of my head in my clairvoyant space, and I put up a reading screen out here in my living room. It's like an IMAX size screen. And I ask the collective energy of Aries Rising to show up on the screen in the form of a lotus blossom. And I'm bam, it is a teal blue. Like, no, it's not even teal. It's more sea glass blue. And it is open. You're loving the spring right now. April's been a big shift in energy for you. So you're just kind of dancing in the breeze. It's not a rigid lotus blossom at all, but you're open and you're kind of going with the flow in this beautiful sea glass blue. So if you've ever been in an antique store, and it just popped out. I have a sea glass blue bottle over here. It just like, that's the color right there. Here's a video of what I'm seeing in my house. And this is the color that I'm seeing you at. And what I do with that color is I keep my crown chakra at gold, my halo at 24 karat gold when I do readings, and try to do it throughout the day, but you know, I'm human. But when I'm doing readings, especially, I keep my vibration at gold, and then I change it to that sea glass blue color. And I put that sea glass blue color on there. I'm going to keep some of my normal gold on there. I'm going to throw some yellow on there just to be a little different. And that's tuning into your frequency, just like I'm tuning into a radio station or a television station. I'm going to tune into the frequency of Aries Rising. And when I tune into that frequency, the first thing that comes rolling onto the clairvoyant screen is a wheel, a big wheel with wooden spokes. Oh my gosh, so much symbolism in that. And when I see that symbol, I ask it for more information, right? What does a wheel mean? And it's like, as soon as you ask a symbol a question, it's like ChatGPT. It's gonna give you a ton of information and download and into your brain all of this information. And when I say you, I am saying yes, you also have the soul skill of clairvoyance that you can tap into and do exactly what I'm doing. And I talk about this in my upcoming book, The Divine Compass, and I'm going to be talking about it here on the YouTube channel more, because I want everybody to be able to utilize their soul skill of clairvoyance if they want to. So the wheel has shown up, and what that is saying, okay, so I'm getting the Wheel of Fortune, which is a tarot card. It's also a TV show, which I loved as a kid. So you have Wheel of Fortune and things turning around in your favor, something, you know, maybe it's been a dull moment or you've had a downturn and it's coming back up. So you have the Wheel of Fortune. You also have the Dharma Wheel, which is actually what it looks like. It looks like the Dharma Wheel, and there's all these spokes. And Dharma is not like karma. It's like your life's purpose. It's like your soul's code. It's what you are kind of here to fulfill. So if you've been stuck in a rut, like the wheel, that's where we get it from. Those old wheels got stuck in a rut. And if you've been feeling like you're stuck in a rut, this symbol is telling me, and spirit is telling me, that it's going to actually, that's interesting. No, it says back up three steps and then move forward at a different trajectory. Oh, I'm so glad I caught that really quick. My dad used to always say this, 3 steps back, 10 steps forward, 3 steps back, 10 steps forward. That there's always a little back pedal readjustment, 10 steps forward. And that is what I'm seeing. Back up, instead of trying to trudge forward in the rut, back up 3 steps, change just an ever slight degree of an angle more towards your dharma, what is more aligned with who you are as a being, then you don't even have to push forward anymore. The wheels just then just start rolling, because that's what they actually are meant to do. They just will roll on infinitely once they're out of the rut. So that's a very interesting. There's something else in there. I talk about in reality creation and even in the miracle experiment, I talk about the rays of life. And you may see these type of self-assessments everywhere where there's a wheel and you have different sections of your life in between the spokes. You have your romance section, you have your work section, you have your friendship section, right? We have these sections that make a holistic life. And this wheel of life, or I call it the rays of life graph, is something that you can tap into and you can go, where's my level of satisfaction in this area of my life? Where's my level of satisfaction in my relationship space? Where's my level of satisfaction in my workspace, my body space, my mind, heart, spirit space? There's all these spaces. And then you can self-assess where your satisfaction levels are and where you need to put more energy. Something may be lacking that's causing your wheel to be wonky, and spirit saying to assess that wheel of life, those rays of life, and see where you're diminished or not feeling energized, and back up and maybe apply some energy into that level, into that space, so that your wheel's more rounded, so that you can move forward. Does that resonate with you? I am not Aries rising, but it resonates with me, and I need to apply this. So let's take a look at your tarot cards for the day. I stay tapped into the clairvoyance and I interpret the cards based on traditional meanings. And I also utilize my clairvoyance, because sometimes things pop out in the cards clairvoyantly that I've never saw before, because I have my clairvoyant hat on and I'm looking at things. I'm open to that. So we're going to pull 4 cards for you today. And the first card is going to be your money prosperity space. And the second card is going to be your work space. What are you bringing out and producing in the world? And your third card, so I just kind of clairvoyantly see that sea glass blue color light up in front of me. And the third card is relationship space. And the fourth card, it's right there, is your next step. So card number 1 is your prosperity space. And it's the art card. Oh my gosh, I love this card. And this card has developed so much more meaning for me lately. I've been doing a lot of work with the sacred secretion work. And this card really represents that. So I've been utilizing it in my meditation as I do the sacred secretion practice. In your prosperity space, this is saying to bring 2 things together, to bring your spirit and your emotional self together in the cauldron. She pulls these 2 things together in perfect harmony, the perfect balance. If you have too much fire it evaporates the water. If you have too much water, it puts the fire out. But if you bring a balance and you alchemize the right balance of fire and water together, it creates this alchemy and it creates steam, which propels you forward, which fuels your steam engine and moves that wheel that I saw in the clairvoyant space. Interesting. What else is very interesting that I'm seeing today is she has a wheel there right on her chest. She has a wheel of life right on her chest, and she's balanced in her heart. When we were talking about getting that right balance, that right alchemy, and then bringing these, your fire and your emotions together, and it, you can see it channel up into fueling her heart space and bringing this energy, this creative force into her prosperity, into her abundance space. So there's a lot of balancing of the chi is what I'm hearing of spirit, not squandering your creative energy. When I was at Berkeley Psychic Institute in their clairvoyant program, we talked a lot, especially as women, about this creative energy, this creative force. And if you do Tai Chi or Qigong, you utilize this chi energy and you can manipulate it and move it and have it flow not just through your body but through your space and through your aura, and you can cleanse and you can own and you can utilize this creative energy in the way that you intend for you. And spirit is saying, do not squander this energy by having loose boundaries, by allowing people to just come in and utilize that creative force for themselves. Or sometimes like we do is we like to go, oh, hi, partner, you're not doing anything with your energy. Let me use my energy and help you create something in your world, even though they're not, you know, this person. Do you know this person, Aries Rising? Do you know this person in your life that isn't doing anything for themselves, or what you feel is not enough for themselves? So you're utilizing your creative energy and spilling your seed, so to speak, into their projects and not saving it enough for yourself. So that may be where that wheel is off balance for you. And spirit is saying in your wealth and prosperity space, to manage your chi, manage that creative force, set some boundaries up. It's going to be interesting because I feel like there's going to be another card about boundaries in here somewhere. Set up some boundaries and own your power for yourself, because having that energy for yourself is going to magnetize your prosperity and abundance to you. So that is your prosperity space, the art card. Let us look at your workspace. Your workspace, the Seven of Swords. This is the mind trip. I was going to use the F word, but it's YouTube. This is the mind where you have a great idea. The Ace of Swords is perfect clarity. It's aha, hallelujah, choir is playing. You've got this brilliant idea, and then immediately your mind is like, nah, not gonna work. You're not smart enough for that. Nah, 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 nah. You don't have an education. You don't do nah, nah. You know what I'm talking about? Just dumb shit that is just dumb. It's not even real, but it's so negating and invalidating. It's the self-invalidation that we do when we have a wonderful, cool idea and we immediately negate it and sabotage ourselves. Woo! So that we don't produce the work that we're supposed to be fulfilling in our life. Oh, gosh. That really resonates. I completely do that. I just did a video about the law of attraction and the miracle experiment that talks about why the law of attraction doesn't work for so many people. And it's because of this, right? Thoughts are things, our thoughts and our feelings create our reality. But then what do you do about this? Because this shit comes up as soon as you have a positive thought and a positive emotion about what you want to create in the world, something comes along and it's your own head that negates it and cuts it down to size and destroys the clarity of the Ace of Swords. And then you don't do it. Why bother? What's the use? It's not going to work anyway. Yep. So this card is saying, dear Aries, to maybe put the miracle experiment in practice. It's under the video about it is law of attraction versus the miracle experiment. In my thing, I give you the three steps there and utilize it to where you can. It's a quantum consciousness hack for hacking the law of attraction and materializing and manifesting in no effort. And it just kind of backs up and goes around this energy so that you can materialize what it is that you want in this world. Because that is your divine birthright, to materialize and manifest your reality and the way that you want to live it. So card number three is your relationship space. The sun. This card, my grandma used to always say, Shannan, you fall into shit and come out smelling like a rose. 3 steps backwards, 10 steps forward. It doesn't matter what negative crap, what weird little snafus, what little setbacks you have, you always end up coming out with the sun, with collaboration, better off than you were before. It's almost as if the shit fertilizes the goal. Isn't that true? Don't we need fertilizer? Maybe we need that shit in our life to fertilize our growth and to fertilize our dreams and our desires and our manifestations. This is in your relationship space. So this is definitely the collaboration card. Who out there, I'm not talking about the person that's not doing for themselves that you're giving your energy to, but where in your life is somebody that resonates and it vibes with you and your goals that you could do something together and bring 2 people together? They do this and they're really good at marketing, or they're really good at implementing, or they're really good at something that maybe your wheel is not, and you can bring it together into collaboration and it blossoms into something better for both of you. In that collaboration, that's in your relationship space, finding collaborations that fuel your goals. And then last but not least, card number four is your next step. Remember when I said something about boundaries? This is the boundaries card. This is the 4 of discs. In the middle here is that chi. That is your power. That is this power. That is this chi energy right there in the center. And the 4 of discs is coming to say, get some grounding around that. I like to use the archangels sometimes, or roses or lotus blossoms to ground my space. The 4 points, right? North, south, east, west. Set up your centuries to own your space. Put a little bit of a border around it. It doesn't have to be barbed wire. It doesn't have to be 3 layers of razor wire. But set some boundaries up. There's a little moat here. There's a moat. And then there's also some distance. Maybe you need to make some separations from people that are taking your energy and maybe go a little bit into a hermit mode and step back from the world and get some boundaries up around your creative energy so you can utilize that creative force for yourself to fuel your dreams and live out your soul's code. And that is your reading for May 2023, Aries Rising. If this resonates with you, I would appreciate the subscribe and ring the bell for the notification anytime I drop a video so you can check out what your next reading is for June or anything I talk about the miracle experiment, reality creation, and learning how to utilize your soul skills for yourself. Until I see you again, stay gold.